Up to this point, when we've talked about chemical reactions and the kinetics of these reactions, we've talked about reactants being converted directly to products, right? And we know that this reaction is governed by a rate constant, so the rate of this reaction would be equal to the rate constant times the concentration of the reactant to some power here, right? So this is our traditional rate law. However, chemical reactions are not always as simple as they may appear. For example, in this case, the reactants might go through some intermediate before products can be formed. So in this case, the overall rate of the reaction is actually influenced by two different rate constants. Let's call them Ka and Kb. Okay, so the conversion of reactant to intermediate would be governed by this rate constant, whereas the conversion of the intermediate to the products is governed by this second rate constant. Okay, so there's really two steps in this process. There's a conversion of reactants to the intermediate, which we have our first rate constant, and then the conversion of the intermediate to the product, which experiences a second rate constant. Okay, so in situations like this, when the reaction mechanism is not as simple as it may appear, the overall rate of the reaction is influenced by the slowest step. So the slowest step in this reaction we call our rate limiting step. The rate limiting step is what dictates the rate of the reaction. So in this example, let's imagine that the conversion of the intermediate to the product is the slow step. So this is slow. What this means is that the rate constant for the second step, the slow step, Kb, is much, much smaller than the rate constant for the first step. Okay? And since the rate constant for the second step is a lot smaller than the first step, the overall rate of the reaction can be governed by the second rate constant. Okay, so this is an important concept to grasp, is that most chemical reactions proceed through at least one intermediate. Okay, it's not as simple as converting reactants directly to products. And in these cases, the rate of the chemical reaction that we experimentally observe is dictated by the rate of the slow step. And in this unit, we're going to use enzyme kinetics as an example of how multiple steps can influence the kinetics of chemical reactions. So we're going to be exploring enzyme kinetics. And this is a really nice example, a real-life example of a situation where we're converting substrates or reactants to products, but it's not as simple as this direct conversion. Instead, there's multiple chemical events that have to occur. So let's think about this conceptually, and then we'll kind of put those concepts to a reaction mechanism. Okay, so first things first, we have our enzyme. Okay, this here is our enzyme. All right, so the enzyme needs to bind to the substrate. Okay, our substrate here is going to be in red. Okay, so the very first thing that needs to happen is for our enzyme to physically interact with a substrate, right? So this substrate has to bind into this binding pocket. And we need to form this enzyme-substrate complex. So here's our enzyme again. And now, this time though, it's bound to the substrate. Okay, so this is our first step in enzyme kinetics. The enzyme interacting with the substrate. Once the enzyme interacts with the substrate, it can then convert the substrate to a product. And when it does, it can release that product. So we now have our enzyme free again, and we've converted this substrate to a product, which is now a different molecule. Okay, so here we have a product, and our red wedge there was our substrate. Okay, so just to kind of go through this again. In our first step, we have a physical interaction between our enzyme and our substrate. So that was our first step. In the second step, once we have that enzyme-substrate complex, then the enzyme can then convert the substrate to a product. So to get from a substrate all the way over to the product, we have to go through these two steps. So let's take this concept and now put it in terms of a chemical scheme. So in this scheme, we have our enzyme plus our substrate. Okay, and in this case, these physically interact through an equilibrium to form what we're calling our enzyme-substrate complex. Okay, so in the context of rate constants, here we have the rate constant for the first step. And traditionally, when we talk about the rate constant for the reverse reaction, so for the conversion of our enzyme-substrate complex back to the enzyme and substrate individually, we usually refer to this as K minus 1. So K1 refers to the formation of the enzyme-substrate complex. K minus 1 refers to the breaking apart. Once we form this enzyme-substrate complex, it can then be converted to the enzyme plus products. And this step is governed by K2. Okay, and here K2 is the rate constant for the second step. And as it turns out, this second step is the rate determining step. So I'm going to put RDS here. So RDS equals the rate determining step. The reason it's important to know that this second step is the rate determining step is that it's the one that governs the overall rate of our chemical reaction. Therefore, for an enzyme-catalyzed reaction, we can condense this whole mechanism into a rate law for an enzyme where the rate of this reaction equals K2 times the concentration of our enzyme-substrate complex. So this would be the rate law for an enzyme-mediated conversion of a substrate to a product. So let's quickly recap. What we've talked about is that for lots of reactions, there are multiple steps. And when there's multiple steps, one of the steps is always slower than the others. We call this our rate determining step. So then this step governs the reaction rate. So this governs the rate of the reaction. Enzyme-catalyzed reactions are great examples of reactions that go through multiple steps to convert a substrate to a product. And in enzyme-catalyzed reactions, it's the second step, the conversion of an enzyme-substrate complex to an enzyme plus product, which is the slow step. And since this is the slow step, the rate of the reaction is equal to the rate constant for the slow step times the concentration of the enzyme-substrate complex. In the next several videos, we're going to explore enzyme kinetics in much greater detail. We're going to explore one equation known as the Michaelis-Menten equation that does a very nice job at encompassing all of the really important aspects of enzyme kinetics. We're going to see what each term in that equation means, and then we're going to talk about a way that we can manipulate it to actually extract out the really important kinetic parameters.